we took the last 2 days off just to really enjoy and appreciate the success we've had in the regular season. Today was just getting back into it.
The Everblades will host their first postseason games at Germain Arena next Monday and Tuesday before hitting the road to Atlanta. The team practiced today for the first time since wrapping up their record-setting regular season.
NBC2's Andrew McDevitt caught up with the Everblades to talk about what's next for the team.
In this, the franchise's 20th anniversary season, the Everblades made sure it was extra special. They set the franchise record for points and wins, but they aren't satisfied. They sure they won't stop until they hoist a trophy.
You know, I'd love to see Mr. Brush hoist a cup again.
It'd be so much fun. Truly special moment, but you know, it's gonna have to take some work, and I'm definitely ready to put in the work.
The Everblades have been working all season. Their 53 wins set a franchise record and carried them to the Bradham Cup, given to the top regular season team in the league. Fort Myers native Logan Rowe also brought home the award for the ECHL's top plus-minus performer.
Really, with that award, it's all six guys on the ice. So, I mean, I have to thank my teammates, and it's fun playing with those guys. And, you know, most times I'm watching and I'm in awe.
But with all the accolades, including an ECHL Coach of the Year award for Brad Ralph, comes along with it a big target on the Blades' back.
There's absolutely pressure, but that's on us to make sure that we're able to wipe the slate clean.
We need to come ready every night. We need to, you know, we need to live up to those expectations. We're going to start with game one and look nowhere past that.
Their opponent in round one will be the Atlanta Gladiators. The Blades won all 10 meetings between the two teams this season, but records get thrown out the window this time of year.
You just can't take anyone for granted. That's the thing. You've got to stay humble and make sure that you're willing to go to the wall, start of the period to the end of the game.
As I mentioned, the Blades have won all 10 meetings with the Gladiators this season, and dating back to last year, they've won 19 straight road games in Atlanta. A good sign for Blades fans. The series begins next Monday at 7:30. Reporting in the studio, I'm Andrew McDevitt for NBC2.